Now let's take an opportunity to look at the different settings available in the Bryston BDP. Again, all of these settings are available on all generations of BDP. The primary difference between BDPs is how fast they are, and in some cases, sound quality. The BDP-3 is our current flagship player. It's not only the fastest, but also the best sounding Bryston digital player that we've created. Going through the settings one by one from left to right at the bottom, we'll start with system. If at any point you need to take a look at your BDP and determine the number of songs in your library or any firmware version information, system is where you get it. So here you see that with the one hard drive connected, we have 114 songs recognized. You know, that's approximately 9 hours, 10 minutes worth of music. The BDP has been powered on for 16 minutes here, and we've been playing it for about 4 minutes. So this is nice diagnostic information. If you've got any trouble with your BDP and you need to call Moon Audio or call Bryston for technical support, you might be asked for some information from the system menu. Disk information tells you information about the disks that are currently connected to the BDP. BDP-3s ship with an internal 32 gig solid state drive that contains the operating system and the music playback software divided into two partitions. There's a system partition which is read only, it's not corruptible, and there's a user partition where we store settings that that you have elected to save in the settings menu of the BDP. Then you see an entry for the disk that's connected. We currently have connected a 2 terabyte Western Digital drive, and there's one partition on that disk called Untitled. This has a capacity of 1.9 terabytes, you see at the bottom, and you know, we've barely used one terabyte on this disk. Here you can do a variety of operations on the disk. If you install a new disk and you need to format it, you can erase. There's a rescue function if you think you have a corrupted disk. You can also verify the integrity of the disk, run a variety of repair functions. If you need to update your library and you have an especially large library, you don't want to rescan many, many terabytes of music, you can update disks individually. There's also a function to enable a scratch drive. So while the BDP scans the internet for album artwork and other information about artists used in artist view, at some point, if you've got an especially large library, we might run out of space on the built-in SSD, so you can set any drive connected by USB as a scratch disk, as an overflow disk for those settings. Audio devices is another setting that's worth getting familiar with. The BDP can not only output digital audio through its built-in, Bryston-designed integrated audio device, but if you have a USB DAC connected, that will show up in this list as well. The Bryston BDP can output to any one of these devices at a time. If you are having trouble with a USB DAC, for instance, you want to go down to audio devices and check and see if that's been properly recognized by the BDP. Now, the BDP is designed to be a bit-perfect device, whether you like it or not. We don't think it's our place to upsample, oversample, resample, you know, change formats, etc. That also includes not having any kind of volume control built in. There is an option for a software volume control that you can enable on the BDP, which will give you a volume slider that's accessible through Media Player. If you are compelled to use the software volume control built into the BDP, just know that everything runs at 24-bit and a fixed sample rate if you decide to use the software volume control. Audiophiles and purists will most likely keep volume control turned off. You can restart the audio software to in an attempt to recognize any newly connected DACs. Any kind of settings can be saved by clicking Apply. Network interfaces is another good setting to get familiar with. The BDP is originally designed to be connected directly to a network via Ethernet cable. If you don't have Ethernet available nearby your audio rack, or if you don't want to use an Ethernet extender, there are some Wi-Fi options available. As of now, the Bryston BDP-3 is available with or without internal Wi-Fi. The BDP-Pi, the smaller player, can be used with our external Wi-Fi adapter. Any network adapters in the BDP are recognized in the network interfaces section. This particular sample only has built-in Ethernet, so if I want to see settings relative to that Ethernet interface, I simply click on the device. I can see the IP address assigned, the net mask. If I need to fix a static IP address, I can make settings to the IP address, netmask, and gateway, and simply click save. By default, the BDP uses DHCP to automatically have an IP address assigned by your router. Update firmware is a favorite setting. Bryston has a wonderful reputation of releasing many firmware updates per year on all of our BDP devices. Many brands will advertise the fact that firmware updates are available for their digital players, but after a few years, the brand will make a device obsolete and no longer support that device with new firmware updates. Bryston still supports our original BDP-1 that came out in 2009 with firmware updates that are issued today. If you want to update your firmware above what is currently installed, you'll see a notification on the dashboard that says firmware update available. Click update firmware at the bottom and you're greeted with a change log of all the features that have been added since your last update. Once you're satisfied that these features or bug fixes are important to you, simply click update and the firmware will be updated. Depending on your internet speed, it may take anywhere between a couple of minutes and 30 to 45 minutes to download firmware. Once the firmware is downloaded, the BDP runs some internal checks to verify the integrity of the update package and then automatically applies that update and reboots the player. MPD, Music Player Daemon, is the built-in audio software in the BDP. This has a variety of options that you can peruse. Most people leave these options alone. By default, the BDP-3 uses MPD version 0.19.21. The maximum playlist length affects how many tracks you can currently have in your queue. By default, this is 300 to keep you from accidentally adding an entire drive to the playlist at once and therefore locking up the player. The BDP-3 can support up to around 10,000 tracks in the playlist at any given time. Older players or slower players like the BDP-Pi should probably be limited to less than 5,000. Update at startup is a function that scans hard drives for new content every time the device is rebooted. This is not commonly used. It's much easier to simply click update, without having to enable update at startup if you need to add new tracks. MPD Watch is not something that you need to turn on unless asked to do so by Bryston support. Enable tracking of MPD stats. Again, this is really only useful for support. And then remember MPD state. This will remember tracks that are in the playlist even through BDP reboots. If you use Last.fm to keep track of tracks played, you can enter your username and password here, and the BDP will scrabble tracks to Last.fm and keep up with your music listening habits. Once you're satisfied with any changes made to Music Player Daemon, simply click save. The BDP is basically a purpose-built computer for dedicated high-resolution audio playback. We have developed an operating system and software suite that is highly stable and usually does not present problems to the user. However, if you have trouble, it might be useful for you to look in the system log for any kind of hints of what might be causing that trouble. There are a few different sections to the log. MPD, System Web Server, Samba, and Bryston Front Panel. Primarily, users would be concerned with Web Server, which runs the GUI, the Graphical User Interface, and MPD, which is a log of the goings-on for the audio software. So let's have a quick look at MPD. Looking at the MPD log, you can see a list of tracks that have been added to the database. At the bottom, you can see that we've played some tracks, and we don't have any kind of trouble spots to look for. We see the BDP also recognized our Bryston BOT1, so there's some indications of proper use there. If you are having trouble with the BDP updating your entire drive, if it appears to be hanging during update, you can look in MPD log to see if maybe there's a corrupted track or some other sign of trouble in your library that's preventing the BDP from updating it. If you're having problems with the user interface operating correctly, you might look in Web Server and see if there's any kind of errors that are presenting themselves based on activities that you're trying to complete in the BDP. By and large, the system log function is not something you're going to have to use unless you have to contact Bryston support. Power users might enjoy a startup script. For those of you that are familiar with Linux, if you need any special functions to happen at boot up, you can enter those in startup script. So for BDP users that have an NAS in the house, a network attached storage device, you need to know NAS setup. Any NASs that are already configured will appear in this section. You can click on any of those and update the music database. You can edit the settings for the NAS. You can remove it. Most importantly, you want to add a share. So once you click Add Share, the BDP is going to scan your network for any shares, you know, any shared file systems on the network. Those will show up under Devices. So here, DC01, we click on it. SMB, it automatically recognizes that as a Windows share. You can enter your username and password, your credentials for accessing the NAS. Once you have your credentials entered, simply hit Next. The NAS is now logged in, and we can see any available shares. Services is another menu to get familiar with. Here you can access a variety of optional services in the BDP. MPD is the built-in audio playback software. Unless you're using Rune or UPnP or some other music playback, MPD should remain turned on. Samba server allows any drive that's connected to the BDP via USB to be published on the network so that any other device can access it. That makes it especially useful to move new music from your computer that you've purchased, maybe from HD Tracks, you know, 7 Digital, Acoustic Sounds, or other places, to the drive connected to your BDP without having to physically move the drive. USB Mount is a service that monitors any devices that are connected to USB, such as thumb drives, portable hard drives, etc. Service Mode is a good one. The BDP includes this feature called Service Mode, which allows myself or Bryston technical support to log directly into your BDP and troubleshoot issues that you might be having. If you call Bryston service and describe an issue to us, we may ask you to turn service mode on and give us the service ID so that we can log directly into your BDP. So in order to do that, simply click service mode, press the start stop button. The BDP reaches out to our server online and is assigned a service ID. So when we ask you to turn on service mode, we'll ask you for this service ID. Give us that number so we know which BDP to log into. Once you are done or we are done, simply click start stop to turn the service off. Rune is an increasingly popular playback method that allows you to use the same software to play to multiple devices around your house. Rune Ready, again, is a bit perfect software that utilizes individual capabilities of each device on your network. If you want to enable Rune Ready, you can either do that from the dashboard with the drop-down menu as illustrated before, or simply click Rune Ready here and start stop. Rune Ready will start on its own, as indicated by on up in the Rune Ready mode. If you need to make any advanced changes to Rune, you can click on the Advanced button. Rune can only output to a single audio device at a time. That can either be the built-in digital audio card, so the AES, EBU, or SPDIF output, or if you have a USB DAC connected, you would want to select that USB DAC instead. If you want to use the volume control within Rune to control the output level, you can enable software volume. If you want to play DSD over PCM, you can enable DOP as well. Simply go save your changes and simply go back when you're done. SharePort sync is a method of sending audio from OSX device or an iOS device to your BDP. With SharePort sync turned on, the BDP will show up as an AirPlay-enabled device on your network. This makes it convenient for you or your friends to play music through Spotify or some other iOS app through your BDP and on downstream to your DAC. SharePlay is another version of that. Squeeze Slave and Squeeze Light are Logitech Squeezebox emulators. If you started your digital audio playback journey with a Squeezebox device like many of us did, and you're familiar with that user interface and you want to stick with it, simply enable one of these and the BDP will show up as an output in Logitech Media Server. The BDP also has some support for UPnP and dlna. dlna comes in three functions. You've got a renderer, server, and a client. If you have a UPnP server and a client set up somewhere on your network and you want to route audio over that dlna network to the BDP, simply turn the renderer on. If you want the BDP to publish its library as a DLNA server, you can turn the server on. If you want the BDP to find UPnP or DLNA libraries that exist on your network, you can turn on client.